The Catholic Church reaffirms its stand on the use of condoms in the fight against HIV/AIDS. Ray Suarez and our Global Health Unit report from Rome.
Throughout the spring, pilgrims and tourists from around the world have poured into the Vatican, drawn by the beatification of Pope John Paul II, putting him on the road to sainthood just 6 years after his death. Also heading to Vatican City over the weekend, theologians, health officials, and researchers for a meeting about the treatment of HIV and AIDS. The church is one of the biggest providers of HIV/AIDS care in the world, with more than 117,000 health facilities worldwide. The conference was convened amid ongoing controversy about the Catholic Church's opposition to using condoms to control the spread of AIDS. AIDS groups around the world had hoped the church would use the conference to announce a reversal of its position. The answer turned out to be a resounding no. Over the past 2 years, Pope Benedict XVI has issued statements open to conflicting interpretation that encouraged some to think the church was taking a more nuanced position on condom use in HIV prevention.
I don't think there was any confusion about what he meant.
But Father Michael Cherney, a key health official for the church, says the Pope continues to believe condoms don't help prevent AIDS.
He mentioned one of the solutions that people tend to promote, and he pointed out that it was not the solution that people think it is. And so they understood what he said, and they disagreed with him very vehemently, very vehemently.
But AIDS advocates were encouraged last fall when the Pope seemed to indicate a softening of his position during a book interview. There may be a basis in the case of some individuals, he said, as perhaps when a male prostitute uses a condom, where this can be the first step in the direction of a moralization, a first assumption of responsibility. John O'Brien, who heads Catholics for Choice, was not at the conference this week, but still maintained that the Pope's comments had signaled a new thinking at the Vatican.
The statement by the Pope was a major game changer. It was a victory for common sense and for reason. It's a sign that what we hoped from Pope Benedict would be that he would be a listening Pope.
Ancora una volta, grazie, Eminenza.
The Pope himself did not attend, but sent his Secretary of State. Most of those attending spoke in support of the church's teaching, but there was some disagreement. Michel Sidibe is the head of UNAIDS, which strongly endorses the use of condoms as a prevention strategy.
I welcome the Pope Benedict's recent clarification of the use of condom for HIV prevention. This is very important.
Monsignor Jean-Marie Mependewatu Musivi was one of the conference organizers.
I think we should read everything in the whole speech that the Pope made, because if you just extrapolate a few sentences, then these few sentences will not give you the whole meaning of the discourse of the Pope. Therefore, you have to go into details and read the entire passage in order to understand the real meaning.
Meaning, in short, that the Pope's statement did not change policy. Catholics and Catholic agencies would not use condoms as part of an AIDS prevention strategy. Sean Callahan is with the U.S.-based Catholic Relief Services, which works with governments and NGOs combating AIDS through the developing world.
As a Catholic organization, we don't support the use of condoms, and we don't promote it. What we focus on is behavior change. The problem you see with condoms is not only the utilization of them, but can they be utilized well? Are they there all the time? And things of that nature. And that is one of the reasons why the church is against it, besides other church teachings.
In a space of a few decades, the condom has moved from being a objects spoken of in whispers to pharmacists, restricted in local sales, hard to get in many places, to something that's near ubiquitous in the 21st century, even available from a street-side vending machine around the corner from St. Peter's Basilica.
Condoms, along with testing, have been the cornerstones of AIDS prevention efforts around the world. But even as the graveyards of sub-Saharan Africa continue to fill up, new infections continue, 1,000 a day in South Africa. Edward Green has the perspective of an AIDS researcher, not a theologian, and he says the numbers bear out the Pope's position.
Certainly in Africa, in the years since 1988, we've seen that greater condom use is not associated with lower HIV infection rates. So yes, they've been oversold. People who do use condoms tend to have a false sense of security and take greater risks than they would take if they were not using condoms at all.
A man I spoke with outside Johannesburg in 2009 showed the lack of acceptance of condom use in Africa.
I am a man. Uh-huh. I have to sleep with another woman.
Right.
And at the site, I have an original woman.
I understand. But if there's a risk of AIDS, how come people don't stop and say, okay, only one?
They won't. They won't stop. They won't stop.
Until they die?
Until they die, because they don't believe in condoms, you know. They are living a true African. I'm an African. I want to use a condom.
Kevin Dowling is a Catholic bishop who wasn't invited to the Vatican conference. We spoke with him last week as he met patients outside his rural clinic. Dowling has been on the front lines of the HIV/AIDS epidemic for nearly 20 years and runs one of the largest AIDS treatment programs in South Africa.
We do not distribute condoms. We give people the information they need to make an informed decision in conscience about what they are going to do in their lives.
Bishop Dowling sees what he calls the injustice and degradation of transactional sex, or survival sex, among the poorest women, and says there's protection in condom use.
The option to be faithful to a single partner within marriage just does not obtain in these situations. That is where the issue of the use of a condom, not for contraceptive purposes, but to prevent the transmission of a death-dealing virus, comes into play.
Again and again at the Vatican meeting, church leaders stressed behavior change, chastity outside marriage, and fidelity within marriage.
We have to educate on chastity. We have to strengthen families. We have to work on change in sexual behavior. Chastity is joyous.
Were promiscuity not endemic, HIV would not be an epidemic.
Catholic Church officials also strongly condemn the tendency for poor people to get poorer medical care around the world, especially those suffering with AIDS, and repeatedly stress the promise of AIDS drugs, antiretrovirals, in stopping the spread of the disease. But Catholic leaders have daunting advice for married couples with one infected partner: long-term celibacy within marriage.
Quindi per amore si può anche astenersi.
The key issue is that the couple should refrain from risky behaviors. They should abstain from sexual intercourse because this is very risky for them. And the church is very, very close, very near to these families to help them achieve this goal.
On the day of the Vatican conference, Catholics for Choice ran an ad in one of Italy's most influential newspapers, Il Corriere della Sera. It thanked the Pope for saying condoms can prevent the spread of HIV and continued in part, "We believe in God, we believe in caring for each other, we believe condoms save lives." Groups like Catholics for Choice will be disappointed by the Church's strong restatement of long-standing prohibitions on condoms under any circumstances. But despite the disagreements, governments still need the resources and expertise of the Catholic Church. They will not turn away what is still vital, life-saving help over condom policy.